I'm Commander Ryland, my lord. I apologize for my abruptness, but I'm afraid I must request assistance with an emergency. Something is stirring up the jungle beasts, which makes the route between here and Kaas City hazardous. Several individuals traveling on foot have disappeared. I've even had reports of jungle beasts attacking speeders.
I fail to see how this is my problem, Commander.
My lord, the situation is more complex than a few hungry predators. Permit me to explain. I dispatched two commando teams into the jungle to clear out the beasts, but they never returned. An emergency holo message came through from one of the team leaders. I'll play it for you.
Repeat. Landing beacons are emitting some kind of energy. Power surges are driving the beasts mad. Can't get close enough to reroute power. Lost my team. Beasts closing in. Need reinforced.
Sensors confirm unusual energy readings in the jungle. The spaceport's landing beacons appear to be the cause.
Just tell me where to go.
I'm deeply grateful for your assistance, my lord. The spaceport's landing beacons are scattered throughout the nearby jungle. You'll need to reroute power on all of them. I'll track your progress from here. Return when you're done. Good luck. The jungle predators are fierce. Welcome back, my lord. Sensors indicate you rerouted power to all the landing beacons. Analysis indicates they were deliberately sabotaged to drive the jungle beasts insane. I am transmitting a full report to Kaas City. Please accept this and my deepest gratitude, my lord. I bid you good day.
Why are you blocking this road, soldier?
When the speeders were pulled off the line, people started braving the deeper jungle, trying to make it to Kaas City on foot. Had a few deaths, some of them VIPs. Captain Tolto sent us to keep people out and poke around a bit, see what's out there.
It's nice to see the Empire protecting its citizens.
Yes. Some assignments are definitely better than others. We managed to take some data readings, even some holos. Big nasty critters out there, nothing to mess with. Our runner, unfortunately, is down a leg from the experience. If you're headed back towards the spaceport, could you give the observation dish to Captain Tolto?
I can and will. Keep up the good work, men.
Thank you.
I have a report for you, Captain. It seems there are monsters in the jungle.
Thank you, my lord. You do us all a great honor by taking notice of our problems. This is what I needed. I'll start moving to warn everyone off that path until we can get some full cleanup squads.
A second of your time, please. Mind a 20. Imperial Intelligence.
Talk, but make it fast.
You're a new face on Droman Kaas. That presents a unique opportunity and a small window in which to use it. I need you to meet a man. Go where he says and do what he asks. There's little danger. But you must not question him.
I'll play your game, but if this is some sort of setup, I'll hunt you down.
Of course, my lord. The man is named Manda, and he is in a local cantina. Tell him the Lord of Sorrow sent you. Good luck. We will not speak again.
Seven brutal bloody murders? Seven? And the killer is allowed to walk free? Decent, law-abiding citizens, loyal servants of the Emperor are being slaughtered. And what do our security forces do? Nothing. I've seen the killer myself, but the authorities say I don't have enough proof. I demand justice.
Why are you yelling at me?
I apologize for raising my voice, my lord, but these murders cannot go unpunished. Not when the killer is so obvious. Several days ago, I spotted a bounty hunter following people seemingly at random, but pointing a strange device at them. The descriptions of the murder victims exactly match the people the hunter was following. He's behind these brutal killings, I know it!
Only a coward kills defenseless people from the shadows.
And only a brave guardian like you can bring the coward to justice, my lord. I followed the killer this morning. Saw him skulking into the Mandalorian enclave. Someone called him by name, Renegan. This bounty hunter must learn the Empire doesn't tolerate gutter scum like him killing its citizens. He needs to be punished.
Manda, the Lord of Sorrow sent me.
Listen carefully. I can say this once. A Chiss security officer stands at the bank. Hand him this gambling chip. He will give you a small item and further instructions. Now walk away casually.
All better.
I have a gambling chip for you.
And I have a package for you. Do not open it. Better if you don't even look at it. There is an NK line droid. I'll show you where to find it. The package goes there. Long live the Emperor.
I have a package for you.
For me? How wonderful. And I, in turn, have something for you.
to show appreciation. If we have not caught the Republic's attention with this sequence, they simply aren't paying attention. Empire forever.
Got a shuttle to catch. You mind getting out of my way?
You've been a bad boy, Rennigan. Murdering innocent citizens.
Now hold on. I never killed anybody who didn't have it coming. You've been listening to Wrightson. Great. Listen, I didn't murder anybody. I was just hired to tag some random citizens, that's all.
You admit you're mixed up in these brutal murders, then?
No! I never touched any of those victims. My clients did all the killings. I was hired by a group of Sith to organize games for them. Didn't realize what that meant until bodies started piling up. When I confronted them, they laughed. Said Sith have a birthright to hunt lowlives. It's like a sport to them.
That has fiasco written all over it.
Sooner or later, there'll be a witness to one of these killings. I don't want to be around when that happens. I'm in over my head, and too many people are watching me now. So I can't even leave. I need help, and I'm willing to pay for it. You interested?
Tell me what I can do for you.
I just want this problem to go away. And I only see two ways for that to happen. Either get rid of the loudmouth pointing fingers at me, or end that sick game the Sith are playing.
I think your clients need to find a new hobby.
Works for me. I'll have a plan that'll get them so good, no one will have to worry about fallout. Take this hunter tag. Use it on Sith acolytes all around the city. The acolytes will become my clients' new targets. Don't worry. I'll make sure they survive. Come back when you're done, and I'll pay you. My clients already ambushed one of the acolytes you tagged. Wish I could have been there. Attacking Sith is a major crime, even for other Sith. I sent the authorities an anonymous tip to watch the acolytes closely. When my clients jumped the ones you tagged, they were arrested and executed. Best work I've done in a long time.
Those murderers were not true Sith. They deserved death.
You won't hear me arguing. My loudmouth friend ought to shut up, now that the killers have been caught. That should make life easier. Here, take these credits. Couldn't have pulled this off without you. See you around, friend.
Exactly as reported. A degree 6 revolt, population equivalent to the Duros uprising on Xilior. Subjects occupy a moderate radius of jungle. Good. Good. Welcome, apprentice. Your timing couldn't be better. I am Lord Drow. When the Empire encounters resistance on its conquered worlds, they call me. I'm here to end the slave uprising on Drummond Cass.
You enjoy your job, don't you?
Dominating lesser beings and squashing their will to resist? Of course I enjoy it. I think you will too. Situation is this. A Sith Lord was constructing a colossal statue of himself in the jungle. His slaves revolted and armed themselves. The Colossus remains unfinished and well-armed slaves now control the jungle. An embarrassment for the Empire, but an opportunity for me.
Sounds like the perfect opportunity to thin the slave population.
Slave deaths will be a byproduct of my plan, but not the focus. I'm testing a toxic weapon, a poison called Quell. Its victims experience a prolonged state of agonizing pain before finally dying. The victim's allies are so horrified by Quell's effects, they lose their wills to resist. At least that's what I intend to prove.
That is deeply disturbing.
That's one of the things I love best about it. I need someone to introduce a controlled amount of Quell into the slave's water supply so that I can determine the proper dosage. Work is dangerous. There will be armed slaves everywhere. But your success will be well rewarded. What do you say?
Anything for a fellow Sith.
Superb. Then let's get started. My assistant, Sergeant Slerin, will recommend the correct dosage of Quell and give you a supply. See him at the research tent.
If I know Lord Drow's tastes, which unfortunately I do, he sent you for the Quell toxin.
Are you implying something, Sergeant?
My superior appreciates a particular sort of talent, that's all. What if I told you this experiment is pointless? That past studies have shown increased suffering has no impact on the speed of surrender. This has nothing to do with accelerating the end of a rebellion. Lord Drow simply takes perverse thrill in gratuitous suffering.
I see no problem here.
It's a matter of efficiency. There's no good reason why our mission here must be prolonged. I want this assignment over with. The faster this rebellion ends, the faster I'll be reassigned to more important work. Serving Lord Drow's bloodlust has stunted my career. If not for his inefficiency, I'd be a captain by now.
Your ego is overinflated.
I know my potential, just as I know who's holding me back from achieving it. Lord Drow's dosage of quell toxin will have slaves writhing in agony for pointless weeks, during which this area will remain volatile. I've prepared a dose that will kill the slaves efficiently, which is better for the Empire and for me. Will you deliver my dosage instead?
Let's end this revolt efficiently and kill off these renegades.
Wonderful. It's the right thing for everyone. Well, almost everyone. I'll give you a maximum dose of quell toxin. Inject it into the slave camp's water filtration systems and see Lord Drow afterward.
I don't understand why it didn't work. I was meticulous with my measurements. Those slaves must be more fragile than I thought. The quell you put in their water supply is killing them outright.
The shock of instant death will throw the slaves off balance.
Shock? I'm not interested in such brute force. All my research is now useless. Oh well. You did as I asked, and your payment was not contingent on the results. Here, take your credits and go. I have a great deal of thinking to do.
My lord? Look at them out there. They're like animals. Hundreds of slaves with no one to command them and without a thought in their minds as to what to do with their freedom. Like I said, the slaves are animals. But we've noticed strange behavior in the pack. And my superiors want to know more. Some of the slaves are killing each other. We don't know if they're mad or hungry, desperate, or if there's a faction of slaves who've turned on the rest.
I can see how a slave civil war would prove useful.
Exactly what the higher-ups are saying. That the killers could potentially be manipulated. We know that the killings are ritualistic. The murderous slaves come in the night, stab their foes, and paint themselves in blood. If you could investigate, catch them in the act and take them down, maybe you could find a clue to their motives.
The slaves will give up their knowledge to me.
Look for any slave who's turned on his peers. With luck, he'll lead us to answers.
You. You're not the initiate. You are Sith. You honor us with your presence, mighty lord. Welcome to our prison.
Start talking, but move wrong, and I kill you.
You want explanations? I am Traka Unvor, leader of the Unchained. I am master of my hatred. When the other slaves broke free, I laughed. Like you, I knew their escape was a delusion. For only Sith possess true freedom.
You know nothing about the Sith.
I know the Sith code. Freedom comes through power. Through victory. I saw a chance to prove myself. I culled weak from strong. I began to kill and to teach. I showed slaves freedom through bloodshed. Now my followers and I are the masters here. And soon, we will become Sith ourselves.
I'm guessing insanity runs in your family.
Look how these pathetic free men tremble at the sight of me. Now, glorious lord, you can spread word of us to the Empire. Give us your blessing, and we shall serve. Carry our message of allegiance to your masters, and we will become the new face of the Empire. We will be champions of the dark side.
You're nothing but a murderer. What you're doing is disgusting.
My lord, how can you say this? All we've done, the blood we've spilled, it has all been for you. Tell us then, how else may we achieve true strength and respect of the Sith?
You've made too many mistakes already. Surrender to the Empire, and you might redeem yourselves.
But we believed. I believed. I will spread your message to the others. We will do as you say.
It's good to see you back. I knew those slaves couldn't hold their own against you. I take it you managed to track down one of the murderers. What's their story? Can we use them?
They were crazy. They thought they were Sith.
What? The arrogance! We'll make sure their delusional heresies don't spread. I talked to my superiors while you were gone, and they agreed to compensate you for your work. So, here. More credits than I make in a week. I'd ask you to stick around in case the slaves cause more trouble, but I suppose you have other responsibilities.
I have havoc to wreak.
Yes. Yes, of course. It's been an honor working with you. I hope we meet again.
Hold your position, please, and keep your weapon holstered. The remotes are scanning you now. You check out. Sorry, my lord. We're on the lookout for anyone with Lord Grathen, and I'm sick of letting him stomp on my people.
Some elaboration is required.
Look, stick around a minute. I don't know if you're familiar with the situation, but Grathen's a nightmare. The Sith Lord's gone rogue. He's holed up in his estate past the wall. He's got weapons, shields, and a cadre of scientists developing new tech to use against us. Grathen wants respect and authority from the Dark Council, so in true Sith fashion, he turned on his masters to prove his power. As a result, we have to put up with his lunacy. So if you're here to cause Grathen problems anyway, you might help us out.
I live to serve the Empire.
Here's the story. There are nearly 100 men assigned to this sector, some on the wall, some watching Grathen. 20 are missing. My men. Practically my kids. Grathen stole them, and I want them back.
So what exactly do you want me to do?
I don't know what Lord Grathen wants with them. Maybe he's holding them hostage just to demoralize us. Who knows? But if you're heading to Grathen's grounds, help them get out. Tell them to report back to their Duchess. That's, what they call me.
Duchess? You'll have to explain that.
You try making it as an officer without getting tagged with a nickname. I've got reports saying that Grathen's been transporting prisoners to another wing of his estate. I don't know if it's my people he's moving, but it's worth checking out. Watch yourself. Grathen doesn't mess around.
Shh! Have to be very careful. Lord Grathen's eyes are everywhere. He's suspicious of all strangers. He must be blind to our doings.
I'll be very quiet, but you should tell me what you're doing here.
Good. Can't have the mission ruined by some chatterbox alerting Lord Grathen to my presence. Grathen's trouble, see? Big trouble. Mad scientist type, likes weapons, cyborgs, droids, ergonomic chairs. My mission's to keep an eye on him, watch for anything suspicious. But I don't know what you're doing here.
I'm going to storm Lord Grathen's estate.
I figured as much. Sharp eyes, see? I can tell these sorts of things. I don't mean to be pushy, but since you're going that way, maybe you wouldn't mind helping me out.
What's in it for me?
I got a little spare change for bribes and such, courtesy of Imperial Headquarters. See, my orders are to keep my distance and not enter Lord Grathen's place or cause any kind of ruckus. But I'm supposed to see about a certain prototype turret design the Rogue Lords supposedly acquired. Empire wants it for mass production.
So what exactly do you want me to do?
Lord Grathen's got the turrets hidden inside somewheres. I'd go looking for them myself, but orders are orders. I have to stay put. Since you're going in, you could maybe poke around and see if you can't find the plans to those turrets.
I won't do this for free.
You'll get your pay when you do the job. The thing is, you never get past the turrets unless you take out a guard and get a security badge. The security badge transmits a signal that tells the turrets the badge holder is friendly. So the op is, get a security badge off a guard, find those turrets and grab the plans. Easy, right? I'll be keeping an eye out here, right where you found me.
Authorization. System cannot identify.
Please don't go! Please don't go! What's happening? Are you with Lord Grathen? Are you invading?
System cannot identify.
You're awfully emotional for a heap of machinery.
You don't... I am not a machine. I'm not a droid.
System cannot stop. Reassigning priorities. Operating number 218897.
Please, did the Duchess send you? Please help me.
Your commander sent me to free you and the others.
We failed. Failed to defend ourselves. Grathen's people took us prisoner for experiments. The scientists cut open our heads, put us in droids, Identification model OHK-99. The program was for advanced intelligence. Enhanced combat tactics. Now my body's lying dead across the room. I can see it.
Is there anything I can do?
I'm the last. The others have all been converted. They can't talk, can't disobey. But I know they can still think, feel. Please listen. You could disable us all. Send the shutdown command from our central command console. Please, you could put an end to this. Use the command console. I can't go with you, motor and combat systems non-functional. Please, make it stop hurting.
Violent intruder laying waste to Lord Grathen's compound. I applaud you.
I'm Ismar Bringle, one of Lord Grathen's indentured scientists. I'd like to make your destruction of this place highly profitable.
Now you've got my undivided attention.
Good. We're natural allies, believe it or not. 3 years ago, Lord Grathen lured me to work for him. He promised great opportunities and exciting fields of study. Instead, I became a prisoner, slaving on freakish creations Grathen uses to advance himself. It's a thankless existence.
If it doesn't involve me, I couldn't care less.
Yes, yes, I'm just getting to that part. Grathen cybernetics researchers, a sadistic bunch of scum, developed cyborg body parts that regenerate. The technology will revolutionize warfare. It's worth a fortune. I have a buyer looking to manufacture a cyborg army. You'll get 60% of my profits if you steal the cybernetic researcher's files.
This better not be a waste of time.
You won't get shortchanged, I promise. There is a catch, of course. You'll have to activate the main console by sending override commands from the remote terminals. Grathen protects his computers with lethal security forces, war droids, cyborgs, even genetically engineered weapons. Expect heavy resistance.
I will destroy anything that crosses my path.
I have no doubt of that. Take this data spike. Insert it into the main console at Grathen's central lab. The spike will download all the data we need. When you're done, bring me the spike. I'll arrange its sale and transfer credits to your account. Go now, be swift.
Oh no! Oh, this is a disaster. Simply terrible. Somebody has to stop me! Somebody has to stop me right now!
You're a big droid. Stop yourself.
Oh, if only that were possible. I'm programmed to understand over 100 languages and dialects, and in not one is the phrase on fire positive when referring to a person. Why, of all droids, I was chosen to maintain these awful things and protect their schematics, I will never understand. Oh, if only I didn't have this terrible restraining bolt restricting my actions. I'd destroy the plans to those turrets in an instant.
It's a good thing that restraining bolt's there.
I don't know how you can say such a thing. The turret schematics are stored within my databanks. If the restraining bolt was removed, I could delete them, ensuring that no more turrets could be built. It's the next best thing to disabling the turrets themselves. If you value organic life, you will remove my restraining bolt and let me destroy the schematics once and for all.
I'll remove the bolt so you can destroy the plans.
Oh, goodness, thank you. In just a few minutes, all record of how these vile turrets function will be destroyed. Oh, sweet freedom!
That's just a little dramatic, don't you think?
Oh, you don't know what it's been like, watching Lord Grathen's test subjects burst into flames and shriek in agony. I don't know how to thank you. Maintaining those turrets day in and day out was simply awful. Thank you again.
Stop! You must not steal that precious data, I implore you. Were I not locked in Grathen's science dormitory, I'd face you in person. I can only hope the passion of my plea convinces you. I'm Lanita Drogue, lead researcher of Lord Grathen's cybernetics division. That data you're stealing is my life's work.
I'm glad I'm not you.
Please, you don't fully grasp the significance of my work. Let me explain. I'm the creator of Project ARC. Automatic Regenerating Cybernetics. I have developed mechanical body parts that grow and heal like actual flesh and bone. Making better soldiers is an obvious application, but my dream is to give these lifelike replacement limbs to the victims of war.
That sounds worthwhile.
You understand? Wonderful. Then hope remains. Lord Grathen encrypted my research notes to prevent duplication, but that data spike will download everything and erase the original. You're taking the only copy. Please don't steal that data. Allow me to continue healing the sick.
Healing the unfortunate is worth more than money.
Wonderful. You've restored my faith in others. Although we still have a problem. Unless they think you succeeded, whoever sent you will certainly try again. Download some other data from that console. Anything, it doesn't matter. Deliver the spike as you promised. By the time your contact realizes the truth, my real data will be safely secured elsewhere.
You're lucky I'm indulging you.
I'm thankful I caught you on a good day. Thank you again. Deliver the false data, and everything should be all right.
You've returned. The sounds of battle echoing through the compound was like music. Made me want to dance.
Oh, don't leave me in suspense. Did you download the cybernetics data? Are we going to be rich?
Very, very rich, I hope.
Finally! Oh, I've waited so long for this moment.
Everything is in place. I'll send the data spike to my contacts so they can extract and verify the data.
It'll be raining credits before you know it. I'm so grateful you crossed my path. You've made my dreams come true.
Fulfillment of any fantasies was unintentional, believe me.
I'll take it however I can get it.
Once my contacts authenticate the data, you'll see a sizable deposit of credits.
Let's hope we got everything off that console.
Treat. You're back. I take it you have the plans to the turrets, then? Can't wait to lay me eyes on them. Can't wait to take them back to the Empire.
Those turrets were inhumane.
What? Those plans were to revolutionize Imperial anti-personnel defenses. I'm extremely disappointed. Extremely. Because now, I have to report back that my mission was a failure. And it's your fault.
I have wronged you.
Too late for that, isn't it? Now, if you'll excuse me, I have to see if I can salvage this operation, clean up this mess, save my skin, you know.
I heard there was action in Grathen's place. Not many people make it in and out like that. But I'm not seeing my men. Tell me what you found in there.
For your own good, curb your curiosity.
It was really that bad. I'd heard rumors about Grathen's repulsive methods, and I have a strong stomach, but I feel a little sick right now. I was hoping they'd be okay. What an idiot I am.
They didn't suffer. I made sure of that. It was the least I could do.
Is that right? Well, I actually appreciate that. Guess it had to be done. You got the information I wanted, so you earned your pay. Take it. Those kids won't miss a few credits. Now it'll be time to recruit some fresh faces.
I wish you the best.
Thanks. I'll need it.
Finally, someone who can keep their head in a crisis. Rebel slaves hit my team in the jungle. They stole weapons, supplies. As if that wasn't bad enough, the idiots ransacked our spires for parts. Without those components, we've got a lightning spire building up dangerous energy levels. It'll crater half of Kar City if it blows.
Unfortunately, this is where I get off.
Wait, the Empire needs someone with your talent. Most of my men ran off. Some tried to reclaim the spire parts, but the rebels cut them down. I came back here for reinforcements. We need to recover the components the rebels stole and get that lightning spire back online before it goes critical.
Do I look like I want to die?
I'd be long gone if I thought we didn't have a chance. At least give it a shot. The rebels are camped along the river. Blast them down, pry the stolen components from their hands, and then reinstall them at the spire. If the river runs red with rebel blood, I'll throw in something extra.
You can relax. I replace the spire components.
I was just about to call in evacuation orders for the city. Well done. The rebel slaves will think twice before tampering with Imperial property again.
You're good to go.
I've sent 3 separate expeditions into the Dark Temple. Not one has returned. I can't say for sure what's going on, but people who go in there, they don't come back.
And here I thought bravery was a requirement for the Imperial military.
Maybe if you think being scared of something that kills Sith is unreasonable. You can survive the Dark Temple. I beg you to do me, and more importantly, the Empire, a favor. The expeditions I sent in were looking for specific data. I can spare the manpower. They were slaves, mostly. But the data is essential.
You don't have the authority to give me orders.
You're absolutely right. But please consider that you'd be doing a valuable service for the Empire, and you'll be extremely well rewarded. All I'm asking is for you to find the data the expedition collected. If all you find is bodies, bring back their data pads. This information is vital to future construction on Droman Kaas. Please help.
Stop talking. I'll do it.
I'll mark the location the expedition last signaled from on your map. It's the best I can do.
At last, the Dark Council has answered my petitions and sent a powerful fighting Sith to help secure the temple.
I'm just here to check the plumbing.
Of course, I've been ignored again. How stupid of me. If you're here, however, you must have the authority to enter the Dark Temple. You could still save this planet.
What are you babbling about, old man?
You're a brave one, aren't you? Or is it that you sense my weakness? But not everything grows weaker with age. The Dark Temple is ancient, built during a previous incarnation of our empire. 1,000 years ago, our own emperor buried his enemies here. These enemies remain powerful, even in death, which is why the temple was sealed. But now, something terrible has happened.
I don't like where this seems to be going.
With the Emperor's attention elsewhere, a group of ambitious but ignorant Sith thought to gain power by raiding the temple. They didn't find the relics they sought. Instead, they awoke an ancient Sith Lord, Lord Kallig, and their expedition plunged into madness.
Are they still in there?
The ones who still live, yes. Because Lord Kallig died by ambush, I believe he awakened unaware of his own death, and his expectations became reality. For those around him, his power overwhelmed all inside the temple. And even now the workers plot wars against each other, believing themselves Sith Lords, and drawing terrible power from Kallig himself.
I'm quickly losing interest.
You are lucky I have no other to turn to in this dark time. There are still more ancient Sith Lords whose spirits lay dormant in the temple. If the ancient Sith Lords are woken by the violence within, they could overrun Droman Kaas.
I was just thinking of getting off this planet.
If the other ancients awake and escape, there will be nowhere in the galaxy safe from their wrath. I have studied all of the burial chambers within. Each was made with the same ancient design, one we can exploit. If you fuse the 500 kilogram hinges on each tomb door, even a violent assault should not be able to wake the ancients.
There won't be a heart left beating.
That will not stop the next group of idiots from putting us right back in this situation. The team I sent in earlier was using a massive metal torch, effective, but slow, I'm afraid. They did not make it far. The torch must be recovered, and the doors of the ancients sealed. Do you dare approach the great Nil Venerus, Lord of the Sith, master of the undying darkness? Answer me. What insolence brings you to this place, slave?
You don't look like a Sith Lord, and you wear a slave collar.
What? You're not afraid of me? You aren't a mindless puppet like the rest of them? I don't understand.
I still have my senses, but someone here is out of his.
You're right. I was out of my senses. But not anymore. I was part of an expedition sent by the Empire to measure strange activity in the Dark Temple. But soon after we entered, we all became different people. I became the mighty Lord Venerus, and the others became my obedient followers and servants.
You seem normal enough now.
Yes, for some reason the madness no longer has its hold on me. Like whatever's causing this dream is losing its power. It's strange that you seem to be unaffected. In fact, it's strange to find you here at all. I thought the Imperials gave up sending people in here. What exactly are you doing here?
I was sent after your expedition.
So the Imperials haven't given up on getting their precious data, after all. This is lucky. You see, ever since I came to my senses, I've been worried that my followers will begin to doubt my leadership. I can't lose my power. I can't go back to being a slave. But maybe we can help each other.
It wouldn't be hard for me to eliminate you and your followers.
Well, I guess that's true. Except I'm the only one who can make all the others turn in their data. All I ask is that you find the symbols of Lord Venerus's power. They were looted from his tomb by the people possessed by Venerus's enemies. The symbols will help me reinforce my followers' belief in me, lock them in their dream.
I bring the symbols, and you give the data.
Be careful. Venerus's old enemies will put up a good fight.
Enter and hear me. You mustn't kneel. I would gain no satisfaction from it. So, you've finally found our hidden temple. It's long since time. The followers of the Dark Path battle my forces, and your cruelty is needed.
This temple isn't exactly hidden. There's a path from Kar City.
Do you mock me? No one finds this temple nor this planet by accident, nor without my approval, for I am Lord Farshaw. I oversaw this temple's construction, and I have ruled the jungle ever since. Now you will serve me.
You're not making any sense. The Dark Temple was built centuries ago.
You are confused. I remember clearing the jungle and laying each stone, and I am no immortal. Now do as I require, and the riches of the temple will be yours. The teachings of the Dark Path lured my apprentice and Yara away. But I will have her back. You will retrieve her from the temple depths.
How can anyone survive in the temple?
Whatever do you mean? Many live within the temple. It is our only sanctuary on this abominable world. I do not know how my rivals reached my apprentice, but I know where she went. The Dark Path hides near here. Kill the followers of the Dark Path. Fight your way to their altar, and Inyara must confront you. Do this, or be punished by my power.
I don't believe you have any power.
Doubt no longer. Witness a demonstration of my strength. Now you've seen the power of a Dark Lord of the Sith. Now we are finished.
You may be Sith, but something is very strange here.
The followers of the Dark Path are not far. Go, and I will await you.
Hello, stranger. My internal chronometer tells me it has been exactly 963 years since this hologram was made. Have the Sith truly lived in fear of me for so long?
I guess that would depend on who you are and who you ask.
A careful answer. But you certainly don't need to fear me. This image is all that remains of Kelithur. Like so many before me, I challenged the Emperor and was buried in this temple. Fortunately, I had just enough time to make this, an interactive image that would transmit my secrets to whomever was bold enough to find my tomb and unlock it.
I unlocked your tomb, so start transmitting.
Patience, and everything will become clear. The way of the Sith lies in channeling the Force through the use of powerful emotions. Fear is the chief of these. The Sith feed on palpable dread.
I love the taste of fear.
It's a lie. Fear is a lie. Passion, a lie. Fear gives temporary power, and passion is easily manipulated. Real strength in the Force comes when one is no longer afraid. And one can purge fear when one stops grasping. After power, after things, after life itself, and allows the Force to guide him. There is only the Force.
What do you mean, there's only the Force?
Just that. Everything there is, life and death alike, is wrapped up in the Force. What I learned only lives on through this image and its device. Yet I am one with the Force, eternal and at peace. Take them. Take my teachings to the Sith. They will find power there, but a different kind. Not of darkness, but light.
The world must know what you've learned.
The Sith should know fear is not the only way. As for me, my message is concluded. I will now depart.
Stay back. I don't know you.
You aren't of the Dark Path. She whispers to me, tells me to go back to Lord Farshall, that I belong to Farshall, but it's wrong. Something's wrong.
Tell me what happened to you.
I was someone else. Before I came to the temple, I was powerful, I was Sith. But she keeps saying I'm an apprentice, just an apprentice. And I hate her, but my hate isn't making me strong enough.
You're no longer in danger.
I came into the temple from the city. I remember the lights of the citadel, and then she pushed it all away. She says she's Anyara. She says we serve Farshall. She says there's no city out there, just jungle. Tell me who's right. Am I the temple apprentice Anyara, or is she lying? Is the city outside real?
Kaas City is real. It's where you're from. This temple is all wrong.
I knew it! Kaasa! She's still in my head, but she's... She's my enemy, and I am Sith. I can defeat her. I will.
Is there anything I can do?
No. I'm struggling, but I'm also remembering. It takes concentration. I came from Kaas City, like you. But the temple makes people think strange things, remember being different people. I'm not an apprentice. That workman, he isn't Lord Farshall. But we thought we were. We played the roles. We even had the power.
No one's making me think strange thoughts.
No. Whatever seized me seems to be distracted now. I was able to escape, and you seem immune. I don't know how long my mind will stay my own, so I need to leave here now.
Get moving, then, and be careful.
I suggest you leave the temple quickly, before thoughts enter your head, too.
Ah. My spies tell me you found the Dark Path, and it seems you survived their fury. Did you find Anyara? Did you see my apprentice there?
Anyara's not your apprentice. None of this is what you believe.
She is determined to remain with the Dark Path, then. How disappointing. Still, you struck a blow at my rivals, and the Dark Path will not move against me soon. You may leave with your life. Take this reward, a token in acknowledgement of your efforts, and go.
The outcome was most unfortunate.
Do not try my patience. Go from here now.
My network of spies reports that you crushed my enemies underfoot and found the symbols of power I requested.
It's all yours. Enjoy.
I, too, have been very busy. Here is the data my servants collected before the temple transformed them. Let the Empire make of it what they will.
I hope your face never spoils my view again.
Actually, that reminds me. There's one last itty-bitty little thing you can do, you see. Power is useless without subjects. So, I'd be grateful. When you turn in the data, you'd encourage the Imperials to send more expeditions my way.
You're really every bit as conniving as the real thing. You know that?
Yes. I do think I've finally found my true calling. I can assure you, my gratitude, if you send more slaves to be my followers, will not be insubstantial. You're back. I hope you sealed the chambers of the ancients, Keleth Ur's chamber especially. I'm terrified to think what would happen if Keleth Ur and his crazed ideas were to reemerge.
Actually, I brought something from Keleth Ur here.
What? What's this? How could you? I want no part of this. Please destroy it. Bury it. Steal it away.
We can learn something from this and become powerful.
Clearly you don't understand. Throughout history, the light has endeavored to destroy the darkness. The Emperor was right to murder Keleth Ur for his heresy. Peace, serenity, words for the stifling of the very emotions that drive us.
Wouldn't it be wise to learn the teachings of our enemy?
No, that's not... Wait. Yes, I think I understand your reasoning. Fine. I will take the teachings of Keleth Ur and study them so that the darkness may prevail over the light. Now please leave. The temple is safe and I must take these teachings back to my chambers and make sure they're secure.
The only thing more powerful than the Dark Temple. Any luck getting that data?
Here's your data, as promised.
Hey, you actually came through. Can't say I was expecting that. Can't say it's not a relief. Now we can finally stop sending expeditions in there, wasting all those slaves who should be building monuments to the Empire.
Slaves shouldn't be collecting data anyway.
My superiors may feel differently, but I tend to agree with you on that point. Anyway, I believe that concludes our business here. Goodbye then, and thanks for the data. Your service to the Empire will not be forgotten.